cost data has been collected annually since 2013 as part of the macadamia industry's national benchmarking project. Over the last 7 years, an average of more than 60 farms each season have contributed valuable data on total operating costs, as well as a breakdown of their major expenses. The data reveals interesting trends for all growers and those looking to expand or develop new farms. Let's start by looking at average costs by farm. Within the benchmark sample, there is high variability in both expenditure and yield between farms. Each of the coloured dots on the chart shows long-term averages of total expenditure per hectare against long-term average yield per hectare. The averages are based on data for mature farms aged 10 years or more for the 2013 to 2019 seasons. The grey dots represent farms in the Central Queensland region. Southeast Queensland farms are shown in red, Northern Rivers are gold, and Mid-North Coast New South Wales farms are in green. Although there are some regional differences, it is clear that variability is evident across all regions within the benchmark sample. Another way to look at average costs is by season. This chart shows average total cash costs by season between 2013 and 2019. The error bars show the standard deviation around those averages. Average costs during this period have generally risen each year. Over this same period, average nut and shell price, shown in gold, has also increased. High variability between farms can skew the sample average, so median costs are also shown. These show the midpoint of the sample and can therefore provide a clearer view of typical expenditure. Some farm managers, particularly owner-operators, may invest significant time in their business without paying themselves a wage. This can make comparison with managed farms difficult. Since 2017, unpaid labour hours have also been tracked and imputed using a standard rate of $30 per hour to capture the cost of unpaid labour. The red part of the bars from 2017 onwards show the imputed value of this labour. While generally negligible for managed farms, imputed labour accounted for around 15% of total production costs for owner-operated farms in 2019. Over the last 7 seasons, the median of total cash costs for participating farms was just over $7,000 per hectare. This chart shows a breakdown of those costs into various expense categories. During this period, the most significant costs were employment, followed by crop nutrition, repairs and maintenance of plant, and crop protection. This chart shows seasonal trends for the top 4 expense categories over the last 7 years. While median costs generally increase across all expense categories, employment costs showed the biggest increase over this period. To better understand the relationship between expenditure and productivity, it's important to also look at cost per unit of production. This chart shows average and median costs per tonne of nut and shell produced. Once again, the grey bars show average cash costs from 2013 to 2019, and the red sections from 2017 onwards show the average imputed value of unpaid labour. Median cash costs and imputed labour are shown as steps. The gold bar shows average seasonal nut and shell productivity. Long-term average costs for this period were just over $3,000 per tonne of nut and shell. In contrast to per hectare costs, which have generally risen each year, costs per tonne are strongly influenced by yield, with higher productivity resulting in lower costs. The grey error bars on the chart show the seasonal variability in costs per tonne. This variability is influenced by seasonal fluctuations in both productivity and expenditure. On average, unpaid labour accounted for almost a quarter of total cost per tonne over the last 3 seasons, when imputed at the standard rate of $30. In this chart, participating farms were grouped according to their productivity per hectare to further explore the impact of expenditure. These groups range from less than 1 tonne through to more than 5 tonnes of nut and shell per hectare. The gold steps show median productivity per hectare for each of those groups. The green bars show median total cost per hectare, and the grey bars show median cost per tonne of nut and shell for each group. This analysis revealed a correlation between total expenditure per hectare and nut and shell productivity. This means that there is a general trend of increased expenditure per hectare among farms in the higher productivity groups. The reverse is true for cost per tonne, which become progressively lower as productivity increases. It's important to acknowledge the efforts of those macadamia businesses that have contributed cost data for the benchmarking study. With additional seasons and increasing numbers of participating farms, this data provides important insight for Australia's macadamia industry.